So what is spaghetti code? Spaghetti code is, at the end of the day, simply very, 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 very ugly code.
Hey friends, welcome back. I'm Amal. I'm a Berlin-based software engineer, and I apologize if you click the video on software frameworks and you found a plate of spaghetti in front of you. But one of the aims or goals of software frameworks is to avoid spaghetti code. So in today's video, we're gonna learn what is spaghetti code, and then we are gonna see what are software frameworks, why should you care, most importantly. Then we're gonna pass to software frameworks, the which and the how, and finally we are gonna see if they have any drawbacks and if there is any better solutions in general. Before starting, it's worth mentioning that this video is number 3 in the Software Engineering 101 series. We started the series with the software development lifecycle, then we talked about programming languages, and now we are talking about software frameworks. Then next video is gonna be about software architecture versus software design, and then there will be more series, more videos in this series. Please follow up and see the previous videos if you didn't. If we start with our first and most basic question on what are software frameworks, I would prefer to start with listing some examples of most popular software frameworks today, so that you get the context, at least if you're in case you are totally new. Examples of software frameworks might include Vue.js, React.js, and Angular.js, for example, for JavaScript in the front end. In the server side, for example, we have Express.js for JavaScript, we have Laravel for PHP, we have Django and Flask for Python, and we also have Spring for Java. These are all examples of PHP. No, these are all examples of software frameworks that are specific to certain programming languages that we use either for front-end development or for back-end development. Most of you are familiar with these names I was listing, and some of you are totally new here, so let's try to explain from scratch what is a software framework. A software framework is a bunch of code put together in a package in order to give your projects or your applications a certain structure, as simple as it sounds. So over the years, programmers have found that there are some things that are common between projects and that we should make them as much reusable as we can, and that's from where or that's how software frameworks appeared. So we'll understand first what do we mean by a bunch of code in a package, then we'll understand what do we mean by that this bunch of code in a package helps or actually does structure your project in a certain specific way. The bunch of code in a project in a package, what do we mean by that? If you're totally new to programming, you have certainly passed by the example of writing HTML, JavaScript, and CSS mini projects where you reference a JavaScript file or a CSS file on top of the HTML code, and then you just use whatever is in that CSS file in your HTML code and everything works perfectly. This is an example of using some code in another project or in another code. This is a very basic like simple example that 100% of you should be able to understand if you are here. If we take things a bit further, you have certainly used or like referenced or like imported libraries before that you used in your projects, and that's simply what a software framework is. If you say, for example, React or Angular or Django, it's just a set of files, a set of files, a bunch of code that is written by other developers, by other programmers, by other people. Some major companies, they release their own frameworks and so on. You can write your own small framework if you want. So it's a bunch of code written by other people so that you can simply reference it in your own project, import it, and then use it. And I think by just hearing this, you can tell that the whole point of having a software framework is, can you guess it? Yeah, it's for you to not reinvent the wheel, let's say. Try not to write your own code from scratch at least, or maybe only if it's a very specific, like a project or a specific feature or like a detail among a big project or whatever. But if you're really starting a project from scratch, unless you are a total newbie who's writing some HTML, JavaScript and CSS code put together just to understand what does it mean, a project or an application, then you should be at least following a certain framework. And that's why software frameworks are one of the topics that are like very fundamental and very basic. This is not advanced in any way, so you should be first, you should first learn a programming language, then know which framework to use that's based on that programming language. I will do a screen recording of an example of a very basic application. Guys, we forgot to talk about spaghetti code actually. And now moving on to the next part of the video, but there is an example that falls in between, so it goes with understanding what is a software framework, and it also goes with understanding why should you care and why are software frameworks important and what do we get out of software frameworks. And most importantly, it explains what spaghetti code, and that's the whole point of the video, I think. After that, spaghetti plate. Here, and after that example, the most obvious reason for why should you care about software frameworks should be at least clear for you now, is that it makes your code cleaner and more organized and like more or easier to navigate and to be understood by other people as well as by yourself. Yeah, because sometimes some people write code and they cannot even explain it. If they just don't see it for a few minutes, then they have to like reflect back on it and so on, which seems very awkward for me, but I have seen such developers. Another reason for why to care about software frameworks is well-structured code, and sometimes some certain frameworks structure, specifically I mean, but in general, well-structured code is more performant. It's not only about you understanding your own code or your teammates being able to understand and navigate through your code and having that certain common language or certain common like understanding of what the framework structure is, and everyone can go to wherever they want in the project. It's not about only that, but structure itself makes the code more performant. I can not sure if I can come up with a specific example, but it certainly reduces certain calls, certain redundant code that exists here and there, and so your whole application becomes more performant just because it follows a certain structure. And actually, if you see some comparisons of frameworks, you can tell, or you can see that sometimes you compare them by speed or like not efficiency but like by performance, just because a certain structure makes your application like a little bit better in terms of performance. The third reason for why should you care about software frameworks is we talked about it somehow. Now you don't have to reinvent the wheel, and so you save up so much time. This should be obvious if you're working on a certain like prototype or like structure, and then you're adding up your own customization, then you are saving up time. The third and one of the most important reasons for why should you care about software frameworks is popular frameworks today, they are getting teams to work together. As I said, if you write your code in a certain structure, in general, your teammates are going to be able to understand it because it's organized. In particular, it's organized and structured following that specific software framework. So it's your project is organized and structured following, I don't know, React or following Symfony. And so your teammates themselves will be able to know that because they knew and they learned about React or Symfony. And so everyone speaks the same language somehow. And if we talk about something that gets you to work with teammates and that gets people to understand your work efficiently and easily, then we are talking about jobs themselves. And so software frameworks might define which type of job you're gonna be having. If you notice, for example, and again, if you're totally new and you notice in like job listings for IT, you're gonna find React developer, Angular developer, React and Angular are software frameworks in the end. And so software frameworks do not help you only to become a better software developer, writing more structured and better projects and applications and more like performant apps just because they are more organized in terms of code and so on. It helps you become a better or like, no, it's not about a better, but like a more fit of a team member within a team of programmers or a team of developers and within a company or an organization that uses XYZ framework for XYZ project. And so again, if you are totally new, you're gonna have to learn a programming language, but also you're gonna have to think or like study and research which programming framework, which software framework actually to learn or to use. And I think from the software framework to learn, you are gonna know which programming language. But that's the whole point of this series, Software Engineering 101. We started with the software development lifecycle to let you know about everything about software and not just coding. And then we talked about programming languages, and then now we are talking about software frameworks. Then we're gonna pass to a bit more advanced things. But at this level, if you are a total newbie, and even if you're not, you have to keep this software frameworks awareness in mind when learning something new. And talking about being a better fit within your team, I remember I had an internship in Brazil for 3 months with a startup, and that startup team, they gave me the requirements and they said, look, you're an intern, you have this project for yourself, this is the client, this is a translator in between, because when I just started I didn't speak Portuguese. You have weekly meetings with the clients, and by end of your internship just get this, do the website they want, and they will pay us and you're awesome and it's over. Then I had to talk to the developer who is gonna maintain the website after I leave. It was like my last 2 weeks. I had to talk to a new developer which they just hired, and the moment I walked out of the project and I explained that it's, I didn't even explain actually, I was like, hey, I used Symfony and this is a project. She was like, Symfony? And then she said, we mostly use, I don't know, Zend in Brazil or in that region exactly. And she said, if you look for web developer jobs here, you're gonna find most of the requirements are for Zend developers, and we don't really use Symfony, it's so much French and UE style of a framework. And I was like, what? And so all of this stupid story is just to say that working on a software framework sometimes, or most of the times actually, is not just about the project or you as a developer, it's about the market and the companies you want to work on, what do they use and what do they not use, etc. So these were four quick reasons for why should you care about software frameworks. And the more you like you get into software development and software engineering, the more you're gonna obviously care about software frameworks. But the series and these videos are more for beginners, this is from one side. And also it's good to refresh your memory and get out of the line codes and like the compiling and so on, and just learn about some theories from time to time is also helpful. Now we pass to the next section, which is which software frameworks and how. So I'm gonna list up some few like popular frameworks and how to use them. Now that we know what are software frameworks, why should you care? Which software frameworks exist today and how to use some of them? We can pass to talk about if there is any drawbacks, because you always have to keep in mind that there should be some drawbacks. Things are never perfect. Drawbacks, or maybe is there any better options to get these same advantages or even more advantages and so on. First thing that comes to my mind when I think of this point, which is there any drawbacks for software frameworks? It's not really a drawback, but it's something worth mentioning here, is that some frameworks require certain configuration and sometimes a lot of configuration, and some of these configurations are really system related, or like they might be related to how does your how is your network configured, for example, or how does your machine technically work. It might differ from if you're on a Linux machine to from when you are on a Mac, and some certain and if you are on one Windows for sure, there are certain configurations that should be done. And for some frameworks it's sometimes like demanding. You have to learn these configurations because not everyone have the basic skills of these system administration tasks. Luckily, you can find everything in the documentation of every framework, and even if not in the official documentation, there is always like communities to help and so on. But for some people, these basic system administration skills are lacking, and some frameworks require like some certain set of config before actually using them, or even when you are using them. And this gets us to the next point. So I said, even when you are using these frameworks, not at the point of installing or using them or requiring them, you will need some certain types of configuration, and that's when it's really a bit annoying. Another point, sometimes for some frameworks, you have to have certain services in your server. They should be installed and running, and if they are not, you cannot use the framework properly, and so you have to get them and so on. So sometimes this side of using frameworks is a bit annoying. Another point that's not really a downside, but it falls under this category as well, so I kept it here. It's not the framework's fault actually, but sometimes we do use the wrong framework for the wrong project or for the wrong requirement, and sometimes there's a confusion, especially among beginners or like independent developers who are not writing professional software within professional teams. Sometimes you make the confusion of using, I don't know, Vue.js versus Angular, even though they are very similar, but I don't know if I can find a better example. But sometimes we don't really use the correct framework in the correct time or project. So these are the three points under this section or this part of the video I thought I would share with you anyway. It's worth like nothing is disgusting in software engineering. So it's worth discussing such topics because theories are very important, and this is not really theoretical. If you really want me to share some tutorials on how to use, for example, React, because that's a framework I mastered and have worked on, Symfony for PHP, server-side, maybe Express.js and so on, then let me know. I would be very happy to share tutorials, even though the strategy in this channel is for more this kind of videos. But I would love to share tutorials if any one of you requires or needs some help with something. If not, I would love to know if you have seen the software development lifecycle video and the programming languages video, and if they are related to each other, if you felt the synchronicity in this software engineering 101 series, if you think it's helpful, or any other reviews and questions and suggestions. I'd be really happy to read and reply and answer all of your questions. And so see you in the next video, and meanwhile, please subscribe, it's important for you and for me as well. Please subscribe and see you in the next video.